Hi guys, my name is Dan and welcome to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you all of my passion and secrets about Porsche 991 GT3 car on Assetto Corsa Competizione. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and now let's not waste any more time, so let's begin. First, I would like to say that people at Kunas have done really great job creating all of the cars. All of them feel and sound different, as they should. Driving Bentley, for example, is so different than driving Lambo. You need time and practice to know the car and to know its potential and your limits. Having to choose from the likes of Ferrari, Aston, Bentley, Nissan, Lambo and others is often very difficult, especially if you're starting out. Each has its pros and cons, and some are more stable but slower out of the corner. Some have amazing top speed, but there is one I learned to love the most. Porsche 991 GT3 is the star of this video. And before I go in more detail about the setup and its secrets, let me tell you a couple of things. So first of all, give this car some time on track. It will show you why it's so fantastic, because of its ability to brake later than most of the cars on the grid, and the ability to accelerate very early coming out of the corner, you will be like a wasp terrorizing your opponents. Also, pace that Porsche has in corners is really astonishing. To be fair, I have to say there are two things that people don't like and they go hand in hand. So what is it? Well, the car is unstable and many are afraid to drive it because one mistake in the race and you're gone. There is a solution for it, but you will lose top speed. In the end, Porsche is one of the slowest cars on longer straights. Next, I will show you my setup secrets that will help you make your Porsche easy to drive and you will never want to get in another car. I mean, just by listening it, sometimes it's enough. The goal of this video is to help you understand the car. I will give you the values for each category so it will make your Porsche very stable, but also I will help you understand which changes have an impact so you can do it yourself to your benefit, and then you can try things out and maybe get a better setup for different conditions, for a different track. It is something that I think is has much more value to you and that you will be able to use in the future. Porsche is very funky car, has a especially light front end, and that's one of the challenges that we will address today, and you will be super fast in entering the corner, mid corner, and of course exiting the corner, which makes the Porsche one of the best, if not the best car on ACC. Okay, so I've loaded the aggressive preset setup, and the first thing that we will change and will have a huge impact on the car. So I've said that front end is very light. We are going to change caster, and caster values should be put between 9 and 10. So depending on the track, depending on how you cope with it, it will give the front end much more heavy feel. That's something that you really miss when you have these low values below 7 and values between 9 and 10, depending on the track and depending how you feel, will make a huge difference. Another thing that's important is also camber. That's the angle, how much your tires are tilted towards outside, and how much grip you will have when entering the corner. For the dry weather conditions, usually things that you have in aggressive preset are really decent values. When you load the wet setup, you will notice how this angle is getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So I think it's a minus 1.5, which means that there is not much tilt and you want as much surface of your tires to be on the track. So when we are talking about the weather conditions, let me just get back one more time to caster. So if there is wet weather, you should lower it back to around values of 7.5 to 7. You need really to have these subtle inputs when you're entering the corner and so on. You don't want to have that heavy feeling in the rain, because then you will make stronger inputs and thus rotating the car too much and spinning out. One thing I cannot skip, and that's the thing you need to settle first, is the tires. So I think everybody who's been driving ACC knows that the tire pressures should be, when peaking out, so after 3-4 laps, should be between 27.5 and 28.0 PSI. So you will adjust your tires accordingly, so when they're heated up, they're in those values. This is one of the most important things, and if you go below, the car won't feel good, you won't have so much grip. If you go above that range, it's also a very big problem. You will overheat your tires and you won't have enough grip. So after the tires, we're skipping to aero. Aerodynamics is one of the most important things that you will set on your Porsche, and this is the screen where you will have to play first and make your trials first. So the thing that makes your car very slow on the long straights and makes the Porsche one of the slowest in these terms also makes it very fast in corners, one of the fastest in corners. So I think everybody can be fast on the straight line, but the difference is made in the corners, and this is something where Porsche really excels. So I can only suggest that you use values between 10 and 12 for all of the tracks except Monza, Spa-Francorchamps and Paul Ricard, which really need that low wing. Other than that, you will be super fast with this high wing. This will give you stability and also give you a lot of downforce to be fast through the corners, and this is something we want. The other thing that's very important is the ride height. Also, for the front and for the rear, front shouldn't be tinkered too much with. It should stay within values between 54 and maybe 56, 57 maximum. This will make the front end too loose or too tight, and then you will have a lot of problems with oversteer or with understeer, depending on the situation. For the rear ride height, you should experiment with the values between 76 millimeters and 70 millimeters. I would strongly suggest you don't go below. The car really then starts to handle funny, and that's something you don't want. If you've been driving ACC longer, then by now you really know that brake ducts is something that helps you generate more or less heat into your brakes and onto your tires. I usually use the values between 1 and 3 for the rear end, and between 2 and 4 for the front end, depending on the conditions. As I said, if I need to generate more, I will close them down. If I need to generate less heat, I will open them more up. And that's something that's been very straightforward, and I wouldn't want to spend too much time explaining explaining that. Okay, and now we are continuing with electronics. This is something really straightforward, and it depends on a personal preference. I will give you the values that really suit me. So for traction control 1 and traction control 2, in the dry conditions, I use values between 2 and 3. 3 is a little bit more calm and makes a better option for the race. Maybe for a qualifying, you can go for values of 2. It really depends. When there is a wet weather conditions, I go between 4 to maybe 6, maybe 7 in some extreme flooded conditions, and this is something that is pretty much very decent. If we are talking about ABS, then the value is between 3 and maybe 4 for the dry conditions, and maybe around 8, 9, maybe even 10 for the more wet and flooded conditions. It depends. You will find that sweet spot yourself. But these are the ranges that make the car really, really stable. For engine map, in race, Porsche has a really odd engine map, and you should read about it. But for the race, I usually go with 4, which has less fuel consumption, is really steady, and this is something that's very reliable. And when you need more in the race, you can always switch to 8, which is the quali map and is the fastest one. So usually I switch between them. If I need some extra juice, I will go for the engine map 8. As I said, for the quali, you will use engine map 8. And this is the only way to go because it's the fastest. And really something that cannot be skipped is the mechanical grip screen. A lot of fine things here for the fine tuning, also very important. So let's start with brake bias. You would not believe how much or how low this can go in Porsche. So you can move this really, really low, in some cases even to 48%, and then go from this to maybe 51. So for any dry conditions, I strongly recommend you test it out. You see how low you can go until your rear end becomes unstable. And believe me, you will be amazed. And this is something that helps Porsche be the one of the last braking cars on the grid. So you really, really can outbrake your opponents. The other important thing is, of course, anti-roll bar, so the front and the rear. They are being used, so the stiffness of those are being used for the slow speed corners. So when your aero stops working, so when your car is really slow, when your rear wing is not holding the car down to the surface, these are two things that will change how the car behaves. The changes you make should really be subtle and incremental, because this is just the fine-tuning method for preventing your car roll, or you want your car to roll more. It depends. It's just something that will give you more exit out of the corner, or a better turn in into the corner, and you should really understand what you're doing. Other than that, preset values are pretty decent and you shouldn't change them a lot. If we said that ARBs are for the slow speed corners, then we can say that wheel rate is a fine-tuning method for the high speed corners. They just help you stabilize the car and enable you carry more speed into the corner, and of course be more stable exiting the corner. There is not much to say about it. The changes should also be incremental, and you don't have to change a lot from the preset values. In my personal experience, maybe making the car more stiff in these terms just by a small fraction sometimes does the trick, and that's something you should really try for yourselves. The last but not the least is the preload differential. I use personally pretty low values because we have a high rear wing. This means a lot of downforce, a lot of pressure to the rear end of the car, and the lower values help you rotate the car. The only thing you should really watch out is when you're in a high speed corners. If you lift off and feel a lot of understeer, then maybe pushing these values to higher ones will help you with this issue. Other than that, this is pretty much everything about the mechanical grip. Fuel strategy is something that's very self-explanatory. So less fuel, less weight means you're decelerating, accelerating faster. This is usually for the qualifying. The thing that is important maybe is are the brake pads. So brake pads 1 are for the short races, maybe to about 2 hours. Everything longer is with the brake pads 2. Brake pads 3 is the wet race conditions, and number 4 is something that I never used, some kind of experimental brakes that are very unreliable, have different kinds of braking pressure, so maybe you should avoid these. You can also set your pit stop strategy, the amount of pit stops, the amount of fuel that you want, and of course tire pressures for each pit stop differently. This is something very helpful for long races and especially for long endurance races, where you want to have some kind of backbone that you can always relate based on some kind of pre-made calculations. So let's say conditions on the track change, and then you change the tire pressures for 6 hours into the race, and that is really helpful. The better you do it, the easier job you will have in the race itself. In the end, I will show you one setup that is really good for a racetrack that really suits Porsche. That's Kelami. So I will just briefly switch from tab to tab, from category to category, and then you can stop and pause and see setup yourselves. So this is everything about the caster, camber, tire pressures that of course depend on the track temperature and so on. So these are the electronics, engine map at 8. Strategy you can disregard now. This is something for a long race. Mechanical grip, dampers, which are based off analysis of the telemetry, and of course aero. This pretty much sums it up. I will leave here some hints why Porsche is such a great car. Of course, plan to make a video for each track as a guide with the setup and more detail. That will help you drive this car much faster, and help you utilize all the good things that you can use against your opponents with this great machine. Of course, leave a comment, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and everything that goes along with it. You can also tick that bell notification that will inform you when a new video is out. I hope you enjoyed this one, and until another one, have a nice day and bye.